what are you working on?
Hey, Lisa. Oh, just drawing a bunch of Steve.
Do you think you can show me how to draw Steve?
Oh, absolutely. I think Steve is so cute because his shapes are simple. It makes him very friendly and inviting. So he looks pretty squishable and huggable to me.
Where did you get this cool pencil box?
You should ask Alex. She designed it.
Okay, thanks. I think I'm gonna go try to make my own. Hey, Alex.
Hey.
I heard you designed this really cool pencil box.
I did. It's one of my favorite projects.
So tell me a little bit about what inspired you.
So I love tools, and even better than a tool is a multi-tool. So I was thinking about like what's a multi-tool that a kid could use. So this is a pencil box that has like all of your basic necessities. But first, of course, it needs a dramatic opening.
Oh yeah.
Bam. Awesome. So it's kind of like pencil box meets multi-tool meets fidget toy. So all of my favorite things. All of your pencils pop up like this, so it's a nice display, and then you can just put all of your favorite pencils here. These are the ones that come with the kit, but you can fit anything in here with this little elastic, so
awesome.
It's nice and flexible. And then it also comes with a little Steve eraser. You could even show it on the pencil. Cute.
So cute.
Of course, it comes with like just the cutest little sharpener. And then those wings that pop out, they're also rulers. So they can pop off of the pencil box. We have the metric side and the imperial side. And that way you can also use it as a straight edge or even a wiggle edge. And I didn't even mention this, this also comes with a whole set of eraser clay.
Oh my gosh.
So you can like shape your own little erasers and bake them, and then they actually work. It's really cool.
Wow, incredible.
And other side pops off too, of course, and you can swap it, put on the other side so you can have the wood facing out. And then bonus, you can customize this even further by using these very cool pencils that are actually watercolor pencils.
What does that mean?
It means that you can dip them in water and then you can draw on the wood with them. And it's really pigmented.
Wow, incredible.
We should do it.
Awesome, I love that.
Thanks, yeah, it's super fun. I can't wait to see kids take it to school and just show it off to all of their friends because I feel like school swag is so fun.
So fun, yeah. Do I get to make those today?
Yeah, that would be fun. Let's grab a box.
All right.
Whoa, athlete.
Okay, let's grab the elastic and put it on the pencil holder. Make sure it fits under all of these notches. Before popping on the blue hinge to the base, double check that it's pointed to the outside. It takes a little bit of force to get it in, but you should hear that popping noise. Now we're gonna turn this blue piece up and put our two pieces together. And now we can close it up. We're gonna start with the gears. So hold your gear mount this way so the rounded side is on the outside like this. And then we're gonna line up the holes and make sure the gear hole is at the end of the slot.
There are a lot of different kinds of gears. This one is called a spur gear because it sort of looks like the spurs on a cowboy's boots.
Okay, we'll take our first bolt and tighten it in right here to attach the two together. Grab a blue bolt and put it in the other hole. We're going to use our multi-tool to tighten it into place. All right, now that the bolts are in place, we'll move the blue one to the end. Okay, now you'll take the yellow gear and do the same thing on the other side. So you want to line it up and you want to make sure this hole is closest to the bottom. So you can check your gear on the bottom side and make sure it's just in the right place. Okay, now you'll take that green and blue bolt again and we'll put them in the same spots on the other side. Don't forget to grab your multi-tool to tighten the bolts. You want them tight, but you still want to be able to move the gears easily.
Gears are useful for all sorts of things. They're in watches, cars, drills, pretty much everything mechanical. And here, you can see that when we turn one gear, it's used to translate that movement to the other gear. So this one turns clockwise and this one turns counterclockwise, or vice versa.
All right, now I'm grabbing the elastic and putting it between these two screws.
Stop and check. Turn the gears to make sure they fit together and they move smoothly. If they wiggle like this, your screws are probably a bit too loose and you should tighten them down. If you try to rotate your gears and they don't snap back into place, your screws are probably a bit too tight. Loosen them a bit so that everything glides smoothly. So when you turn your gears, the rubber ring snaps it back in place.
It's time to assemble. We're going to make sure the curved edges are lined up together here. And then we'll flip it over. Again, making sure these holes are lining up, and we'll grab our green screws and tighten them into place. For this step too, we want to tighten, but not too tight. We want to make sure those gears are still moving nice and smooth so our pencil box will pop open. All right, now we're going to flip it over. And we're gonna add on our ruler doors. They just pop in. You should feel a little click. And you're ready to go. Now we'll add in our wooden dividers to make sure everything fits in our box. They can go in any of these notches so you can fit whatever items you might have. Okay, I'm gonna put my pencil sharpener right here, and this spot I'm gonna save for my erasers. All right, now we're gonna close it up. Make sure you close both sides, and then you're gonna lock that orange piece into place. All right, let's open it up and see if it works. Woohoo! We made a pencil box. All right, I'm ready to make an eraser. What is this made out of?
So most erasers are made out of things like rubber or vinyl. Eraser clay is pretty similar to vinyl erasers, but it has an extra ingredient that makes it more moldable and mixable, mineral oil.
So you can make your erasers into anything you'd like, but I think I'm going to start by making a pineapple. You're gonna have to work on your clay a little bit to get it started before you can really mold it into whatever shape you want. I'm gonna put some aside to turn it into green later to make some leaves for my pineapple. To make my leaves, I'm gonna take a piece of yellow and then just a little bit of blue. I'm mixing the clay together since yellow and blue make green. And just like that, you have green. All right, first leaf done. And I'm just gonna place it right on top. All right, now for some finishing details. You can use the pencil in the crate to sculpt your designs as well. All right, we're ready to bake. Before we bake, we want to make a little clay stand for our little erasers to sit on. This helps make sure that our eraser is not going anywhere and the base isn't going to get too hot in the oven. You want to make sure you're just lightly putting it on so it doesn't get too stuck on there. Once your erasers are ready, ask a grown-up for help so you can use the oven. I suggest turning the oven to 250 degrees for about 5 to 8 minutes. Be sure to stick around and watch to make sure the clay doesn't melt or burn. All right, I got my pineapple ready to go, but I'm gonna add a few more of my creations. I know you'll wanna use your eraser as soon as it's finished, so do I, but wait, it's not ready yet. Your eraser is super hot and it still has to set. Let it cool for at least an hour.
While you wait, think about this. Even once you've baked it, the eraser clay doesn't completely harden. It's still bendy and, well, rubbery, like an eraser. Plus, its surface is rough enough to loosen up pencil smudges while also being sticky enough to pick up graphite dust.
All right, they're ready to go. We'll just pop off the base like that. If they're a little stuck, you can always grab some scissors and have an adult help you cut them off.
Wow, these are so cute. Is this a tiny KiwiCo Labs crate?
It is.
Oh my gosh, it's adorable.
Thank you.
Oh, and this can pop on a pencil?
Yeah.
Cool. Oh wow, that's adorable. I love it.
All right, I'm all done. What do you think?
It looks great.
I also added waggle eyes on the gears.
Cool. Can you open it?
Yeah.
Ah, so fun. Cool.
Could you give me some tips?
Yeah, there's a couple of tricky steps. So first, right now yours is opening perfectly. But if these screws are over-tightened back here, it'll cause this whole assembly to clamp down. It'll be a little too tight, and then they'll open really slow. So if that's happening to you, just use your little wooden multi-tool to loosen these up, and then they should glide open, no problem.
So what should I do if the box isn't closing right?
Yeah, so if it's not closing, you're probably just having something crash on the inside. Maybe you've put a little too much inside the pencil box, or maybe it's not organized. So right here, when I'm doing this, it's crashing into my Steve pencil eraser because the sharpener is behind it, blocking it. So if I just organize this a little bit better, use my dividers, then I can close it, no problem. And of course, all of your pencils should stay firmly in place inside of this holder. If you're noticing that they're loose or they're falling out while they're in the pencil box, check to make sure that the pencil is in front of this elastic band, not behind it.
All right, got it.
Now that you've built it, let's make it your own. We can use these watercolor pencils. I'm very excited that we were able to include rainbow watercolor pencils, and then each side has a different tone. Very cool. And there's a couple different ways to try and get that watercolor effect. So one way is to dip them in water like this and sort of try to saturate the tip. And I like to like wipe off any extra. And then we can just draw straight on the wood.
Nice.
You have to go back and forth a little bit, but you get this really nice, strong pigment when you do it this way, which I really like.
That looks great.
And there's another way to do it too. So I'm gonna use the red for this. So this way we can draw with it dry. So this way we can draw with it just like a regular color pencil. And then I can add water afterwards to get that watercolor effect. So I'm just getting a little bit of water on my paintbrush. Brushing it on.
Oh.
Yeah, and then you can see that it sort of like erases all of the strokes, and then you get that more saturated paint look.
Nice.
Yeah, so cool. And then if you wanted, you could go a step further and blend colors together, just like in real watercolor painting. Wow, it's beautiful. I love it.
Thank you.
That's so fun. Cool, you even got some like color mixing in between the colors in the rainbow.
Oh yeah. Thanks for building along with us. If you'd like to see more fun videos, please subscribe.
Wait, I thought that was my line.
Do I get to make some of those today?
Yeah, you want to?
Yeah.
Okay, great, let's grab a box.
All right.
Somewhere.
Yeah, but nobody really includes indigo when they do a rainbow.
No, because it's not in the song.
What's the song?
Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple. These are the colors of the rainbow.
Were you a preschool teacher?